Ivanovich and key player of the team Azizbek Turg'unboyev. Assalomu alaykum, matbuot anjumanimizni O'zbekiston milliy terma jamoasi yordamchi murabbiyi janob Vlado Radmanovich va jamoamizning yetakchi futbolchilaridan biri Aziz Turg'unboyev bilan davom ettiramiz. First of all, Mr. Vlado, how do you have your expectation before the match?
Yeah. Good day for everyone, the first and the second. I like to explain some things. Unfortunately, we again stay without our head coach, Katanes. I suppose that you understand and that you know what happened with him. If you don't know, just a short before 2 days, he didn't feel good and he explained us in the morning, I'm not ready to be next match on the bench. And we suppose that he has some private problems and we didn't like to ask them what kind of problem he has because they are private problems.
Many high-level players here. First number bosh murabbiyning holati haqida ma'lumot bermoqchiman. Afsuski, ushbu uchrashuvni bosh murabbiy Fesho kompaniyasida o'tkazamiz. 2 kun oldin shunday holat bo'ldi. Ular aytib o'tdiki, o'zini yaxshi his qilmayotganiga haqida ma'lumot berdilar va o'zlarining qanday shaxsiy muammolari ham borligi tufayli ushbu uchrashuvda ular biz bilan muloqotligini ma'lum qildilar. Biz so'raganimiz yo'q, aynan qanday muammoligini, bu barchamiz uni shaxsiy hayoti.
Yeah, and my opinion is that he believes us and that he believes you because all we are Zbornaya Komanda, not just we, all fans and all people of Uzbekistan is Zbornaya Komanda. And we believe him and I think that we have good abilities that we will do that job good.
Demak, biz barchamiz ishonamiz terma jamoaga, chunki bu birinchi navbatda terma jamoa, bosh murabbiy ham bizga ishonadi, biz ham futbolchilarga ishonamiz, biz umuman butun o'zbek xalqi o'ylaymanki O'zbekiston terma jamoasiga ishonishadi va biz shu terma jamoa sifatida qo'limizdan kelgan barcha ishni amalga oshiramiz.
And about game, tomorrow we play the second game with Hong Kong. In the first game we won 2-0. And tomorrow we have right and hope that we will play good and that we will have a good result.
Demak, ertaga Gandumga qarshi 2-chi marta maydonga tushamiz. 1-chi o'yinda o'zingizlarga yo'q bo'ldik, 2-0 hisobda g'alaba qozondik, yaxshi o'ynadik. Ertaga ham xuddi shunday yaxshi o'yin va yaxshi natijaga erishishga harakat qilamiz.
Of course, we respect every team and we respect Hong Kong, but of course we don't scared about them. And we come to underestimate them, it could be
dangerous.
We analyzed the game and we analyzed that our game with them in Hong Kong. And we saw all their weaknesses and good abilities, and we know our abilities, and we are absolutely ready to one good match tomorrow.
Avvalambor assalomu alaykum. Ertangi bo'ladigan bahs ajoyib bo'lishi kutilmoqda, chunki jamoamizdagi barcha legionerlar to'liq tarkib bilan harakat qilyapmiz. Mashg'ulotlarda hammamiz o'zimizni ko'rsatib, bor kuchimiz bilan harakat qilyapmiz. Xudo xolasa ertangi bo'ladigan o'yinda ham borimizni berib, o'zimiz uchun muhim bo'lgan 3 ochkoga erishishga harakat qilamiz.
Kelyapsizlar.
say to tomorrow's game, we will try to win and good results and for our fans and our teams. All of them want to win the game and qualify next stage. Marhamat, savollar bo'lsa, jurnalistlarimizda.
Qo'mitada bitta jamoaga qarshi qimmat o'ynash nima og'irdi? Bitta jamoaga qarshi mumkinmi?
It's always difficult to play against the same team in a short period, two games. So do you expect some kind of surprises for the game tomorrow?
Yeah, it's right here. We don't have enough experience in that, and there are special matches, and just the biggest problem is how to find more team. And that problem we will, about that problem we say that our motive will be not the highest level, will be not the nearest level, must be optimum. And that is the bigger job of this problem.
Bunlar haksız. Bizler bunda İstanbul'da çiğler baktılar artık yaklaşık kime atamaydı onu yapışmış tazikler sağlıkça çabuğundan. Bu yöldeki en asosiy masala bu maçlar sarılan da olur. Biz yeterliçe maçlar sarılmış bu oyun yandaşımız gerek. Biraz maçlar sarılmış yeterliçe olmasa bu ayı kökenizi halkan da nasıl buluşun bu maçlar.
Of course, if they are motive on the open level, they are too much press, they are too tension. In that case, it's must be some problems of if motive is too low, it's not good. That engagement is not safe, whatever. That's, I repeat it, motive must be on the optimal level.
Motivasyon yeterli derde oluşturuyor. Yani ki yani ortada ama mesela ki yani ortada pizza bu hoşunca basın bir flaşın bir zaman gel. Ayrıca yani pasta mı mesela ki o sebepten şu niye o kadar zorlayıcı ki yeterli motivasyon oluşturuyor.
Savollar bo'lsa.
Murad aka savolim, ertangi o'yinda Murad aka aniq bo'ladimi? Ya'ni bosh murabbiy bilan o'zgarishlarni bilan maslahatlashgan holda amalga oshiradi.
So tomorrow during the game you will have some kind of communication with the head coach. For example, if you want to make some substitution, are you going to ask the head coach?
Yeah, we are in communication with him. And we know the team. We talking about that before he's gone. And he will see him watch that game on the TV. Of course, we have phones, we have kind of a communication. That will be okay.
Albatta, biz bosh murabbiy bilan aloqada bo'lamiz. Ular ketishidan oldin ham bosh murabbiy bilan qanday o'ynash to'g'risida gaplashib oldik. Jamoani barchamiz juda yaxshi bilamiz. Va ertaga o'yin davomida ham turli xil vositalar orqali, telefon orqali albatta aloqada bo'lamiz. Bosh murabbiy ertaga o'yinni shu televizor orqali tomosha qiladi.
Siz o'sha navbatda boshlaganingizda deyarli hujumchi sifatida o'ynagansiz, lekin hozircha esa Katani sizni o'sha o'ng qanot to'liq vinger sifatida foydalanmoqda. Muxlislardan savol tushgan, o'zingiz uchun qaysi pozitsiyada o'ynash kerak? To'g'ri aytishingiz mumkin, terma jamoa uchun istalgan joyda bilmayman. O'zingizga qulayroq joy qaysi?
Menga qulayroq endi oldindan o'ynab kelgan joydim qanot yarim himoya sifatida o'ynash. Endi siz aytgandek zbornida murabbiy aytgan joyda o'ynash kerak. Endi asosan baribir yarim himoyada o'ynaganim uchun ko'proq atakalarga qo'shilishga harakat qilyapman. O'shani hisobiga bu pozitsiya ham menga yoqdi deb o'ylayman.
So the question was for the player. So as we know, before you used to play in your club in position of attacking midfielder or attacking winger, but now in the national team you have to play as a defending winger. So how do you feel? Which position more comfortable for you? So the answer of the player was that yes, of course, I feel more comfortable as a attacking midfielder, but as we know in the national team, I have to play in another position as a defending winger, so even in this position I feel really good, really comfortable because
chose here.
It's
different, you know, it's different when you have four backs, classical backs. All that four backs are defender, absolutely defender. And you know, if you know, the first system who played with three was Michel Hidalgo, French coach, and he destroyed that system with three backs and two wingers back. And they are not classical back. And Mr. Trubogoyev is not classical back in this system of the game. And sometimes he is defender, and sometimes he is a midfielder, sometimes he is attacker. Because there are new tasks in the new systems there.
Demak, birinchi navbatda ta'kidlash kerak, 4 ta himoyachi bilan o'ynash va 5 ta himoyachi bilan o'ynashdagi qanot himoyachilarining roli bu butunlay boshqacha farqli emas. Birinchi navbatda shu fransuz murabbiyi Mishel Hidalgo 3 ta markaziy himoyachi bilan o'ynash taktikasini qo'llashni boshlagan va aynan ushbu sistemada qanot himoyachilari kerak bo'lsa himoyada, yarim himoyada va hattoki hujumda ham harakat qilish imkoniyatiga ega bo'ladi va Aziz Qurbonboyev aynan mana shu pozitsiyada shu sistema bilan
That's mean when team lose the ball, when team lose the possession of the ball, that players, wingers, backs are defender, and again when we have the position, they are midfielder and attacker.
Demak, jamoa to'pni topganda qanot futbolchilari himoyachi vazifasini bajaradi. Biz yana to'pni qaytarib olganimizda ham yarim himoyachi, ham hujumchi vazifasini amalga oshiradi.
Oxirgi savol.
Savol, birinchi savol Mansur Umarovga edi. Biz terma jamoamiz Gonkongga borib, qaytib kelyapti-da. Gonkongdagilar shunchaki O'zbekistonga keldi. Bolalarda charchoq alomati sezilmayapti. I murabbiyga savolim. O'zbekiston terma jamoasi 5-5 himoyachi bilan o'ynash taktikasiga tobora o'rganib boryapti. Gonkongga qarshi o'yinda misol uchun shunaqa osonroq raqiblarga qarshi o'ynaydi, 4-5 himoyachi taktikasini qo'llab ko'rib biroz hujumkorroq bo'lsa tushirishi iloji yo'qmi? Misol uchun sal mosto shunchalik gap keladi desam
Bolalarda charchoq alomati sezilmayapti, chunki bu yerga kelganimizdan keyin asosan e'tiborni o'sha vasaritilni upражнениеlarga qaratdik. Hammani hozir holati yaxshi. Xudo xolasa hamma o'yinga tayyor.
So the first question was for the player. So as we know, Uzbekistan for the first game against Hong Kong, we had to travel to Hong Kong and then we came back. So we had a really long flight. But our rivals, Hong Kong, they just had only one flight from Hong Kong to Uzbekistan. So the question was, are our players now more tired? What do you think? And the response of the player is that no, we managed to do enough recovery. And I think that all the players now physically ready, they are fit for the game against Hong Kong. And the second question was for the coach. As you know, the Uzbekistan national team, they have been playing with three central backs with five defenders for a long time, and now we're feeling really good playing in this system. But what do you think against the teams like Hong Kong? Should only say that easier opponent. Maybe we can play with four defenders, maybe we can put more attacking players.
We are all. I think tomorrow in the morning, head coach will decide it about that and about system we will play. But I think we know all. I said all abilities and weaknesses of team of Hong Kong, and we saw some good players there. Especially, my opinion is that big attention myself with. Player number 11 is my opinion that he's a really good player, and number 8 goalkeeper is so good, and they have some weaknesses in the defense, and we will try to do a good job.
Deni murabbiyning javobi ertaga albatta bosh murabbiy bilan ertalab qanday sistemani qanday taktikada o'ynashni gaplashib olamiz. Gonkong terma jamoasini juda ham yaxshi bilamiz, kuchli va kuchsiz tomonlari. Shundan kelib chiqqan holda taktika tanlaymiz. Gonkong terma jamoasini 11-raqamli, 8-raqamli darvozabonini keyin yaxshi deb aytib o'tish kerak. keyin ularni kuchsiz tomonlaridan biri bu himoya, himoyada unchalik ishonchli o'ynashmaydi.
Rahmat. Coach, thank you very much. Azbek, sizga ham katta rahmat.
Thank
you for attending. Good luck tomorrow's game.
Thank you very much for all.